Ganeto.
Hello trainers, Ganeto here with brand new Go Battling content. Today we're playing with a team inspired by a subscriber of this channel. Close Combat Machamp will lead our team, while Empoleon will cover our backs as a safe switch. Metagross will also be there as our sweeper when the shields are down. As always, do not forget to like this video in the end before you go, and consider subscribing to the channel for more Pokemon Go related content. Now let's punch our way to the battles. We are starting off with Mamoswine. That's a very good lead for us, so we're gonna force the switch here, and because they bring into the fight a Metagross, I'm thinking that I have to stick in with my Pokemon, because we have both Empoleon on the back and Metagross, which can absolutely take down the Mamoswine with no problems. Using right here my first close combat, and after that I will go for another one, because I'm pretty sure that they're gonna shield for a second time, and because right now we have our defense dropped by a lot, we're gonna switch out to our Empoleon. We have to block here, because this is most probably 99% sure that this is an earthquake, gonna block correctly, and after that we will try to farm down, but they make the switch to this Magnezone and they cannot go for the wild charge in time, since we can go for the double hydro cannon and finish this magnetic zone down. Down they go with the second hydro cannon, and right here is where Mamoswine will come into play, but they have nothing to throw at us, and we're gonna take the first win since they left the match. Aion 2679 will be our next opponent, and we're facing a Snorlax this time. This is a very good lead for us as well, so we're looking pretty good, and they are having a Metagross at the back as well. This is really interesting. People are deciding to play Metagross as a safe switch, not up in the lead, so let's see how this will turn out for us, because this is a different trainer and has some different options to use. Using close combat, this one is gonna take it, and after that Dragonite will come into play, and we have Empoleon to throw at them. Most people see Empoleon, which is a steel type, and if they have a Tokigis at the back, they are gonna throw their Tokigis at your matchup with a switch, and that means that your Metagross can absolutely come into play and start farming down. Most trainers are not expecting that, so I can absolutely guarantee that to you that a Metagross at the back with another steel type is a very solid option. Using right here my second Hydro Cannon, this will provoke the shield, and they are gonna go for the charge move right here. This is really good for us, because right now this Snorlax has almost no energy, and we can come into play with whatever we like. I decide to go with my Machamp because my Metagross has a better matchup against that Dragonite, and my Machamp here is gonna just wreck this thing out, and we're gonna take this win eventually with our Metagross with that weird bullet punch. Next match, everyone, with Fismallow. I don't know him or her, but we are just gonna wreck them down, because they are having a Metagross up in the lead, and we have a double close combat ready to go, almost ready to go. Okay, I can hear you opening my switch at some point, because they might do a weird switch to that Tokigis if they have one, of course, using the close combat, and right here, if they take it, this is gonna be really huge for us. They take it, down they go, and they have a Tangrowth at the back. We're gonna switch right straight ahead, because we know that Empoleon can take down any grass type with that Drill Peck, but of course we do not run the move Drill Peck, we run double Hydro Cannon here, and we're not gonna go for the Drill Peck for sure, but they do not know that, so they are gonna shield, and the reason I'm running Blizzard is because of Dragonite. Dragonites are not expecting the move Blizzard from an Empoleon nowadays, because any Empoleon is running Drill Peck, so a Blizzard can surprise your opponent and grant you an easy win when you had a very tough loss. Using my Meteor Mask, they are gonna block, and after that I will come into play with my Machamp to use the close combat. They are gonna take a lot of damage here, and we can take this Body Slam for sure. We're gonna faint for sure, but we can absolutely come into play and start farming down with our Metagross, farm up about 2 meter masses, and then finish off their last Pokemon with style and finesse. Let's see here, and after that we're gonna just finish off the match with Metagross, which is really good for us since we have the very best sweeper in our team, and we're gonna take another win. We are heading into the next one and we are facing a Shadow Magnezone. This is one of the best leads that you are hoping to have in Premier Master League with your Machamp. They have a Machamp of their own as well, a lot of people are playing Machamp at the back, and we're gonna bring into the fight Metagross, because obviously we cannot bring into the fight Empoleon, and we want that close combat to stay on our Machamp, no reason at all to spend it here, and then we are absolutely going for that Meteor Mask because we want this Machamp out of the way as soon as possible. They are gonna shield, and at this point I'm like, bring it on, I can shield as well, and then I will farm you down. Here is the cross chop, we blocked correctly, and after that we are just gonna farm down and have about an earthquake ready to go. Expecting the Magnezone, we are gonna fire off an earthquake. Perhaps they think this is a meter mass, and they thought that. Down they go, and here is a Dragonite. Right now we can spend our last Pokemon, which is the Machamp. Actually it's not our last Pokemon, but it is our last hope. It is gonna take out their shield, and right here is where Empoleon with Blizzard comes really handy. Without shields, can absolutely wreck down any Dragonite with that Blizzard. Gonna go for the shield here, I think, no reason to risk anything. And we are actually gonna go for that Blizzard for the overkill, deleting about 100 dragons there, since they are taking super effective damage from that weird spicy ice attack. Gonna fight our last opponent right now, and we are facing a Golark. What did you say about bad leads? Here is one. We are gonna face a Golark, which is absolutely wrecking both, actually, all of our Pokemon, right? Three of them. Yes, all of our Pokemon, because that Mudslap is actually really handy against Metagross and Empoleon as well. Using the Rock Slide here, I cannot go for that close combat for sure. Gonna bring that Golark really low, and I know that I can take this charge move. It is a Shadow Punch. I knew that this thing is having a Shadow Punch, and they're gonna switch out to the Togekiss to faint us down immediately. We had no chance there, and we're just gonna bring into the fight Metagross, gonna block just once, and after that we are gonna farm down all the way, because we know from the bottom of our hearts that we can absolutely win this one. They are gonna go for the RLAs, and I think that I have already 100 energy left on my Metagross. Why not go with my Empoleon and start farming down the Togekiss? Perhaps we can have about 2 Hydro Cannons for the last one, which is the Magnezone, the next one, the last one. They're gonna just block, and we hope that we can get to another one, and we can. This is really good for us. Perhaps they are gonna block for another time, and they do block. Right now they're gonna throw at us the Golark, and here is the return of the Magnezone. They are not gonna go for the farm down, which is a really huge mistake. They're gonna go for this Mirror Shot, and we are gonna bring the Doom to them with the Earthquake, with the Metagross, for the final win of this video, and an amazing sweep with this team. Really enjoyed that close combat matchup. Thank you, subscriber, for letting me use this team, for recommending it to me, and I really hope that you had a nice time watching this content. Consider subscribing to the channel if you enjoyed your time here, and why not? Leave a like before you go if you enjoyed this effort. Take care, trainers, and I'll see you all on the next one.